morning, glorious day that the Lord has made. His mercies have been shown greatly. The miracle of us waking up today, it is by His grace and His perfection. The great God that we serve has shown us great mercy. Even when we least deserve it, He came and caused redemption for us to live. May His name be praised. This morning, we're about to be exalted about His word. I believe by His grace, we are going to be blessed. Let's have a word of prayer before we begin. Father, we thank You, we worship You, Lord, we give You praise, we give You honor. Lord, even as this word is about to be unleashed, released upon Your children, Father, bless this word in their hearts in Jesus' name. Let this word lift their heart above their level of limitation before now in the name of Jesus. Wrap them, O God, with a new living after this exhortation this morning in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. This morning, we want to look at a topic, focus on Jesus. Focus on Jesus. Our text is taken from Luke chapter 10, verse 20 to 25. We'll be reading verse 20 of Luke chapter 10. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the Spirit has subjected unto you, but rather rejoice because your name are written in heaven. Praise God. Focus on Jesus. The word here, focus, talks about giving your 100% concentration to Jesus. Giving your attention to Jesus. Not on the things He might have used you to perform, but rather focus on Him, because He is the lead way to whatsoever you do. Your focus on Him is highly important, and it is of great effect in us. The disciple came rejoicing, and they were saying, the demons, the powers, they were under our subjection. They obey us. And Jesus told them, no, do not rejoice, because you have victory or dominion over the miracle that we have done. But rather, rejoice that your name has been written in heaven. We were never instructed to have a PhD in demonology. However, some people justify focusing on Satan and his activity to an inordinate degree. This will actually encourage demonic activity and become a device that Satan can use against them, as Paul said. We should not be ignorant of Satan's devices. We need to know the devil and demon exist and to recognize the activity, but we need to keep our focus on the Lord. Some people who are excessively in spiritual warfare actually spend more time talking to the devil each day than they do talking to God. That is not right. Many people give more of their attention to their problem than giving their attention to the one who can solve the problem. Many people exalt Satan or no to them, giving much credit to the devil when they can get answer when they focus on Jesus. I am not trying to neglect the fact that demonic activities are all around us. Facts must be told that even demonic oppression oftentimes is not a total rejection of God, but rather that the victory, the testimony to the glory of God, will be derived from them. demonic oppression are not stop sign to God's miracle. But oftentimes many people dwell much on casting and binding the devil, neglecting the fact of the power, the fact and the power of Christ that will give them victory. They neglect it ignorantly, thinking casting and binding will give them victory over the work of darkness alone. Without focus, you cannot have good results. The best defense against this devil is to be, listen, the best defense against the devil is to be so God-centered. It's for you to be God-centered. When you are God-centered, the devil cannot oppress you. That is one of the defense, one of the way to fight the devil. You have to be God-centered, not demonic center, not problem center, not focusing on your fear, but rather resisting your fear, focusing on God. That is the best defense you can ever have. That will give no place to Satan. People who are very sensitive to the devil presence usually are not being sensitive to the Lord's presence. Are you getting me? Many people who give more attention to demonic oppression oftentimes don't give attention to God when it comes, because of the fear and constant fear of demonic oppression. They sometimes lose focus when God is speaking. When David said in Psalm 139 verse 8, he said, "If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there." Anytime Satan oppression is, there is God present. These two, Hebrews 13:5. It is just a matter of which one we focus on. Focusing on the devil is a trick of the devil. Where there is problem, there is Satan and there is also God. The Bible, that is why he said, "Call upon me in the days of trouble." Satan only brings trouble to trick you to fear. But God has given us a remedy to it. Call upon him. Focus on him. Believe on him. Your ability to live the Christian life is found in Jesus Christ. It is not your ability, but your availability to him that makes the difference. Paul said, "For when I am weak, then I am strong." 2 Corinthians 12:10. He was saying that when he recognized his inability and relied on the Lord's ability, that was where the Lord's strength flows through him. Today, you can do all things through Christ. Philippians 4, verse 13. By keeping your eyes on him, I pray the Lord will bless his word in our hearts in Jesus' name. Let's focus on him. Let's take away fear and burden. And our God will bless us abundantly in Jesus' name. By the grace of God, I remain Joshua Osatowane. Don't forget to join me tomorrow for another exhortation like this. Please also follow my YouTube channel. I'm Joshua Osatowane. Another social media platform to hear from God's word or to hear other gospel by me. I believe God will bless us all in Jesus' name. Amen.